अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। वेलकम टू हेरनली स्कूल ऑनलाइन टीचिंग। टुडे इंशाल्लाह इन इंग्लिश वी आर गोइंग टू सी वन ऑफ द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पोयम। इट इज़ अ मेटाफिजिकल पोयम। द नेम ऑफ द पोयम इज पुले। नाउ व्हाट डज इट मीन? पुले मीन्स एक्चुअली many a times you must have seen at the side of the well there is a rope with which the string is been pulled and the bucket is taken out. That is what is pulle. But here we are going to see it in a different meaning. Now this poem is on page number 71. The person who has written this poem is George Herbert. He was born in the year 1593 and died in year 1633. Okay, now he was a Welsh poet. What does it mean? That means he was born in the area of Welsh near England. Okay, now he was by profession a priest. Let us see the introductory part first. George Herbert, 1593-1633, was a Welsh poet. He was a poet by profession. He wrote religious poems with a lot of imaginary and concept. That means with a concern for the people, for the well-being of the people, he wrote many poems. The poem exhibits a strange but two-way relationship between God and human being. Two-way relationship between God and human being. Here, the God bestows or gives away all the things to the human being, and human being thanks in return to God for whatever has been given to the human. But many a times the human beings are thankless. They don't have feeling or they don't respect to God. So that is what is shown here, and the Pule also makes us understand that God bestowed all the things on human being, but he restricted few things. The most important thing in the life of a human being is the rest or the peace of mind, which is being taken away by God. He controls it. Why he controls it? Because if he controls these two things, then only human being surrenders and prays to God for that peace and for that rest in his mind, in his heart. Okay? So we will understand this poem. Though he has showered, bestowed. Showered means given away. Given the blessings to the man. He is worshipped with all his blessings somewhere. He holds them up with a pulley drawn to be grateful to him in all our endures. That means whatever we have got, alhamdulillah, we have got lot many things from God. Each and everything we cannot count. Thousands of things, thousands of blessings, alhamdulillah, have been given to us by God. We should be always thankful to him. But human beings, after getting lot many of the things in their life, they forget God. So this pule is what the God has control of the rest and the peace of mind of a human being in his hand. That's why the human beings surrender towards God and they pray to God for peace and happiness and rest. Okay? Now God gives so many precious gifts to the devotee. Devotee means the human being who is always praying. But at the same time, God also expects something in return. What he wants? He wants that respect should be given to him. His things, his orders should be followed. Rules, whatever has been laid down in the holy books, that has to be followed by human beings. What does he expect? What he expects? Why does he withhold? Why he withhold? So that human being can understand the importance of God. He is the ultimate control. controller of all the things, right? Now, the pulley shows how God lifts man towards himself with the pulley of restlessness. What is distinctly metaphysical about the poem is that a religious notion is conveyed through a secular scientific image. Here what he says is that with the help of this poem, the poet wants the people to be conveyed this message that ultimate the controller of everyone is God in a secular manner. So we will see this poem in. Let us see the first four lines of the poem, The Pulley, written by George Herbert. Okay? See the first line. When God at first made man, having a glass of blessings standing by. That means, when human being was born, because God made him and God made him to stay on this earth. When God at first made man, having a glass of blessings standing by. That means he gave orders to the angel to give all the blessings, all the bounties, all the wealths of this world to man. Not only in the form of money, but in the form of all the facilities, resources available on this earth. Okay? Further we move on to, let us, said he. Now here, let us, in the bracket it is written, said he. That means, it is, he is with H capital, that resembles or that donates or that shows us that it is God who is saying this. To whom he is saying? To the angels. Pour on him all we can. That means God ordered the angels to pour all the blessings, all the bounties or the wealths on human being. Let the world's riches, which dispersed, lie contract into a span. That means let the world's riches. Riches means the wealths, the bounties. Is the meaning here, okay? The wealth, the bounties means not in the form of money, but in the form of all the natural resources as well. Let the world's riches, which dispersed means scattered, which is scattered all over the earth. We have the iron ores, manganese ores, many of the trees, different fruits, vegetables, what not we have, alhamdulillah, as a blessing from God. So he says, let the world's riches, which dispersed lie, that means whatever is scattered on this earth, be all be given away, available to human being. Contract into a span. Contract means collect together. Into a span means small space. Small space which can be accommodated by the human being. God wants to give away all the things to the human beings. Okay? We move on to the further second paragraph. So, strength first made a way. So, the first thing which was given to the human being was the strength. Okay? Then beauty flowed. See, with the help of the strength, he was able to move his hands and legs and he could think. He had the energy in his body. So that is what is the strength and the strength with which he can work hard. Then beauty flowed. That means the beauty was given to him. You will see human being having many beautiful faces. The different features of each human being, their eyes, their skin, their body shape, and all these things are the beauty which has given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the human beings. Then wisdom. That is,
he has a brain which is an intelligent quality which a human being has. His brain continuously working, making many thinking power he is having. So that is what is wisdom. Then the honor, that means the respect given to the human being. How the respect is given? When they do hard work, they are being rewarded. They are being given many praise from the people. So that is what is the honor. And the pleasure. Pleasure means the joy which he gets from his children, from his wife, from all the wealth which is he is having, and all the pleasure life which he is enjoying. Okay? Because of God has bestowed on him all the wealth and all the natural resources, whatever are available on this earth to the human being. When almost all was out, God made a stay. That means when all the things were given away to the human beings, then God made a stay. That means God stopped giving away the things. Okay? What was that stay? Perceiving that alone of all his treasures. Perceiving means noticing, becoming conscious of all the things he was having. Food, wealth, money, house, children, wife, everything. And then something was controlled by God. That was perceiving that alone of all his treasure. He became conscious that what he is not having. What he was not having? Yes. Rest in the bottom lay. That means the rest, the peace of mind he was not having. Even though he was having all the wealth, all the family members to live with, all the pleasures in his life, all the wisdom, all the honor, all the strength, all the beauty. But something was lagging behind. Something was not available to him. That was the rest, the peace of mind. So from where he is going to get that peace of mind? Yes, when he will remember God and he will pray to God. That is what is the control which is there in the hand of God, okay, of the human being. So now we move on to third paragraph. For if, I should, said he, bestowed his jewel also on my creature. For this I say, I should, said he, bestowed this jewel also on my creature. That means God said that if I have given away, I have gave him as a gift to the human beings, this jewel. What is the jewel? The precious, valuable things. That is here the rest, the peace of mind, which are the valuable things. That is the jewel. If I have given away all these treasures, what will happen? He would adore my gifts instead of me. He would adore. Who? This is the human being. Human being will adore. Adore means love very much. What he will love? He will love all the natural resources. He will love all the luxuries available to him. But he will not remember God or thank to God. If he is having all the things available to him, he will become very different. He will not pray to God. He will not remember to God. If everything is available to him easily. Okay? And rest in nature, not the God of nature. Now that man will start praying to the different kinds of natural resources. Like sun, wind, moon, earth, stone, land, soil. Whatever, from where he is getting the wealth, from where he is getting all the money, he start praying to them instead of praying to God. And rest in nature, that means he will be having nature, thinking nature as his God and not the God of nature. And then he will think that nature is only the God, and he will not pray to the God of nature, the God who has created every single minutest item on this earth. Okay. So both should losers be. So he will be a human being, will become a loser if he finds peace and God, he thinks to the natural things. The last paragraph we will see now. Yet let him keep the rest, but keep them with repining restlessness. Yet God has given him all the things to human beings, but keep them with repining restlessness. Repining means continuous anxiety due to dissatisfaction. Why human being is not having satisfaction? Because he is not helping others in the society. He is not helping the poor. He is not taking pleasure in helping to other human beings. He just thinks of himself. He has become selfish. So he is having a repining restlessness in his mind and heart. Let him be rich and weary. Weary means very tired after earning the money, hard work he is doing every day. Let him be rich. Let him means to whom he is talking about? God is talking about human being. Let him be rich and weary, that at last, if goodness led him not yet weariness. See, he should become a human being, should become a quality of human being is to have kindness, to mercy towards the other creatures and even to the fellow creatures of human being. If they will help the others, they will find some kind of peace and gratitude, and they will be satisfied somewhere if they help the other human beings who are in difficulty on this earth. If goodness led him not yet weariness, may toss him to my breast. That means the dissatisfaction, the restlessness, it will bring him very close to God. It will bring him to whom? To human being. Bring human being towards closeness to God, and ultimately he will find peace and pleasure when he will pray to God, remember to God. Okay? This is what the poet wants to convey to us. It is actually a metaphysical poem. It is distinctly metaphysical about the poem is that a religious notion is conveyed. That means God, closeness to the God is conveyed to us. The message given by the poet is that we should pray to God and remember him in all the situations. Okay? Inshallah, we'll continue next time. Jazakallah.